Hi everybody, you will learn the correct use of some commonly confused conjunctions in this video. A conjunction is a word used to connect two clauses. Keep in mind that you can use only one conjunction to connect two clauses. Sometimes we use transitive adverbs instead of conjunctions. They do not connect the clauses, but they also ensure the flow of ideas. So what is the difference between conjunctions and transitive adverbs? Well, in speech, there is no difference that you need to remember. But when you write, you have to put a semicolon or a full stop before a transitive adverb. Most of the time, you will also need a comma after these expressions. Conjunctions are different. They connect two clauses to make one large sentence. If the clauses are lengthy, put a comma before the conjunction. Don't put a comma after it. So in this video, we will learn about some conjunctions and transitive adverbs that express the idea of cause and effect. As you can see here, the conjunctions since, because and as give the reason or the cause. So is also a conjunction, but it expresses the result or effect. Now, in the third line, we have some transitive adverbs, therefore, hence and thus. They are not conjunctions, but they also express the result or the effect. We have two sentences here. It was a pleasant evening. We decided to go out. Actually, you can see that there is a cause and effect relationship between these two sentences. We can connect these two sentences using a conjunction or a transitive adverb. As it was a pleasant evening, we decided to go out. We can also express the same idea using since or because. We decided to go out because it was a pleasant evening. Now actually the because clause can also go at the beginning of the sentence. So you can also say because it was a pleasant evening, we decided to go out. Since it was a pleasant evening, we decided to go out. An as clause or a since clause always go at the beginning. But that is not the case with the because clause. It can go before or after the main clause. Remember this. The as clause and since clause should always go at the beginning of the sentence. And in this case, we put a comma after this as clause or since clause. A because clause can go before or after the main clause. Now, we can also express the same idea using so. I already said because, as and since are used to give the reason. So shows the result or the effect. It was a pleasant evening, so we decided to go out. Now instead of conjunctions, we can express the same idea using transitive adverbs like therefore, hence or thus. It was a pleasant evening, therefore we decided to go out. Note that we put a semicolon before therefore and a comma after it. That is because therefore is a transitive adverb and as such it cannot connect the two clauses like conjunctions. Therefore we put a semicolon or a full stop before it. In the third sentence, it was a pleasant evening, hence we decided to go out. Here also, we put a semicolon before hence and a comma after it. Now, more sentences are here. My brother refused to accompany me. I went to the court alone. Here also, there is a cause and effect relationship between these two sentences and we can connect them using as, since, because, therefore, etc. As my brother refused to accompany me, I went to the court alone. Not the use of the comma after the as clause. As clauses always go at the beginning. Since my brother refused to accompany me, I went to the court alone. An as and a since clause are usually used in formal writing. The because clause is less formal and also a because clause can go before or after the main clause. That means you can start the sentence with a because clause or you can put it after the main clause. Because my brother refused to accompany me, I went to the court alone. You can also say, I went to the court alone because my brother refused to accompany me. You can also express the same idea using so, therefore, hence, etc. My brother refused to accompany me, so I went to the court alone. Or, my brother refused to accompany me, therefore, I went to the court alone. Not the use of the semicolon before therefore. My brother refused to accompany me, hence I went to the court alone. Here also, we have used a semicolon before hence and a comma after it. Common mistakes. I already said you can use only one conjunction to connect two clauses. Do not use two conjunctions or transitive adverbs of the same idea or same meaning in a sentence. This is a mistake that I always see in the essays. I correct, avoid it.
Consider the sentence. As he was angry, so I said nothing. Can you identify the error in this sentence? It has used two conjunctions. As is a conjunction, so is also a conjunction. You have to remove one of them to make the sentence grammatically correct. You can use as or you can use so. You can't use them both. He was angry, so I said nothing. Or you can say, as he was angry, I said nothing. No more examples are here. Because I was the youngest child, so my parents pampered me silly. Here also, there are two conjunctions, because and so. Because expresses the reason and so expresses the result. You can use only one of them in the sentence. You have to remove the other. Because I was the youngest child, my parents pampered me silly. You can also express the same idea using so. I was the youngest child, so my parents pampered me silly. No more examples are here. Since the proposed airport will lead to the development of the area, therefore it is in the interest of the people. Actually, we don't have two conjunctions here, but instead we have used a conjunction and a transitive adverb of the same meaning. You have to remove one of them to make this sentence correct. Since the proposed airport will lead to the development of the area, it is in the interest of the people. Or you can use therefore instead of since. The proposed airport will lead to the development of the area. Therefore, it is in the interest of the people. Here in the first sentence, we used a semicolon before therefore. Instead of the semicolon, you can also use a full stop. The second sentence, we have used a full stop, and in this case, we have two independent sentences. The proposed airport will lead to the development of the area. Therefore, it is in the interest of the people. Now, instead of the semicolon and the full stop, you can also use therefore, hence, and thus as a conjunction. In this case, you have to use it with and. So, here in the third sentence, you can see that we have written and therefore. The proposed airport will lead to the development of the area and therefore it is in the interest of the people. Here in the third sentence, we didn't use a full stop or a semicolon. Instead, we used the conjunction and with therefore and thus we connected the two clauses.
I hope that is clear now. If you like this video, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button, and once you have hit the subscribe button, take a moment to hit the bell button as well. Thank you for watching.